गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, होप यू आर फाइन एंड वेल एंड सेफ एट होम। टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट आवर फर्स्ट क्लास ऑन मैथ्स, दैट इज चैप्टर 1, रैशनल नंबर। नाउ वी सी वी हैव लर्न आवर रैशनल नंबर इन आवर प्रीवियस क्लास ऑल्सो, बट बिफोर गोइंग टू दिस रैशनल नंबर वी विल स्टडी व्हाट फर्स्ट व्हाट इज नेचुरल नंबर। नेचुरल नंबर, सो नेचुरल नंबर द नंबर व्हिच स्टार्ट्स फ्रॉम 1, द नंबर व्हिच स्टार्ट फ्रॉम 1 एंड सो ऑन, सो दिस इज कॉल्ड नेचुरल नंबर। नाउ कम टू सेकेंड नंबर, दैट इज होल नंबर। सो व्हाट इज होल नंबर? होल नंबर इज द नंबर व्हिच इज स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम 0, 1, 2, 3 dot and so on. Now the next one is integer. Integers. Now, what is integers? Integers is the numbers with positive as well as negative. Positive as well as negative. The numbers which is a collection of positive numbers and negative numbers, and also along with 0. So this is our integer. So integer is say -3, -2, 1, 2, 0. So these all are integers. Now we see here integers. Integers are positive integers, negative integers, and 0 integers. So now we know what is natural number, whole number, and integers. Now come to the rational number, which is our chapter. It is rational number. Now, what is rational number? So rational number is the number which can be expressed in the form of p by q. So the number which can be expressed in the form of p by q, that is a rational number, that is numerator by denominator. So also we can say as fraction. So any number of the form p by q is what? Rational number. Suppose as for an example, say 2 by 9. So 2 by 9 is in the form of p by q. So this is a rational number. Now is 6 a rational number? Is 6 a rational number? Yes, 6 is a rational number because this can be expressed in the form of p by q. So if I write here divided by 1, so it is in the form of p by q. So 6 is also a rational number. Now again, 0 is also a rational number, as we can express in the form of p by q. Now you see, any number of the form p by q, but q should not be equal to 0. Now if q is equal to 0, that means suppose 2 by 0, this is not a rational number because 2 by 0 is equal to undefined, not defined. Okay, now this is what about rational number. Now we'll start the few properties of rational number. Now first we'll see what is equivalent rational number. Equivalent rational number. So what is the equivalent rational number? If A by B is a rational number, if A by B is a rational number, and M is any non-zero integer. then we can write A by B will be equal to A into M upon B into M. So you see here A by B is a rational number and M is any non-integer, then A by B is equal to A multiplied by M divided by B multiplied by M. That is, let's say once an example. So suppose 2 by 3 will be equal to this 2 by 3, that is into, suppose 6 is M. So which is equal to 6 to the 12 and 6 to the 18. So this is called equivalent. This is called equivalent rational number. So here you see this 2 by 3 is equal to 12 by 18. Now come to the what is standard form of rational number. Standard form of rational number. So what is standard form of rational number? It is again, if A by B is a rational number, and M is a common, A is a common divisor of A and B, then A divided by B, which is a rational number, A divided by B will be equal to A divided by M, B divided by M. So as an example, you can solve, suppose, say, minus 32 divided by 40 equal to minus 32 divided by 8 and 40 divided by 8, which is equal to minus 4 by 5. So this is, you see this rational number is reduced to this form, which is in the standard form. So now we have seen that equivalent rational number, what is equivalent rational number and standard form of rational number. Now we'll see how to compare two rational numbers. So there is comparison of rational number. So how to compare a rational number, it is which one is greater than the other two rational number. So comparison of rational number. So first, you see every positive rational number is greater than zero. So every positive rational number is greater than zero. Suppose 2 by 3 will be greater than 0. So every positive rational number is greater than 0. The second one, every negative rational number is less than 0. So suppose this is minus 2 by 3. So minus 2 by 3 will be less than 0. Now suppose we were given two rational number, say 3 by minus 4 and the other one is minus 5 by 6. This is 3 by minus 4 and minus 5 by 6. which is better? Suppose this is which rational number is greater. So now we need to compare these two rational number. So which one is greater? So solution, how to do? Now you see here the number, the first rational number 3 by minus 4 and the other one is minus 5 by 6. So first, what we need to do, first we need to make the denominator with positive sign. So first we need to make the denominator positive. Okay, so how to make this number, this denominator as positive? Now you see the first one minus 3 by minus 4. So to make this denominator with positive, we need to multiply minus 4 into minus 1. So 3 into minus 1, so this is minus 3 by 4. So this is our first number. The other number equal to here how much? Minus 5 by 6. The other number minus 5 by 6. So now you see here denominator is 4 and here the denominator is 6. So now in order to compare these two rational numbers, we have to make the denominator same. So how can I make this denominator same? That is, we need to find a common multiple, that is LCM. So what is the LCM of 4 and 6? 4 and 6. So LCM of 4 and 6 is 12. So the first one, therefore, you see minus 3 by 4 will be equal to 4 into 3 minus 3 into 3. It is minus 9 by 12. And therefore, the other one is minus 5 by 6, which is equal to 6 into 2 minus 5 into 2. It is minus 10 by 12. So you see here clearly, minus 9 is greater than minus 10. Therefore, minus 9 by 12 is greater than minus 10 by 12. That is 3 by minus 4 greater than minus 5 by 6. So, this is how we compare two rational number. So, come to the next topic. That is, Now I will discuss about the few properties of rational number. So what are the properties of rational number? So today I am not going to solve any exercise. I am dealing with the introduction of the chapter. That is the concept of the chapter. What are the concepts in this chapter? It is the introduction part. So now we will see the properties of rational number. So first property, that is closure property. So closure property, if you see in this property, I will discuss the four operations, such as it is addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. So, what is closure property? So closure property in case of addition. So suppose A by B is one rational number, and I'm talking about this addition. So when one rational number is added to another rational number, say suppose C by D, so do we get the result also a rational number? So suppose a rational number. So in this property we'll see when a rational number is added to another rational number, the result should be a rational number. So suppose you see 1 by 2 plus 1 by 2 is one rational number, and say 3 by 2 is another rational number. So when we add this, you see I'm taking the denominator as same, because if I take different denominators, calculation will be a bit complicated. So I have taken denominator same number. So 1 by 2 plus 3 by 2, which will be equal to 4 by 2. 1 plus 3 is 4, 4 by 2. So 4 by 2 is a rational number. So our first, so a closure property will works on addition. Now come to the second one, that is subtraction. So again, A by B minus C by D is equal to a rational number. So again we can check, suppose 4 by 5 minus 2 by 5. 4 by 5 minus 2 by 5. This is one rational number and this is another rational number. So the result is what? 4 minus 2 is 2 by 5, which is again also a rational number. So this closure property is also applicable in subtraction. Now the third one, there is multiplication. This A by B is one rational number multiplied by another rational number C by D. So this is AC, so a rational number. So again we can say 1 by 2 into suppose 3 by 2. So this is equal to 3 by 4, which is also again a rational number. So this closure property also applicable in multiplication. Now the last one, there is division. So A by B divided by C by D equal to a rational number. So you see A by B divided by C by D equal to a rational number. Yes, this would equal to a rational number, but we need to ensure that C and D should not be equal to 0. Suppose if C and D is equal to 0, then it will not be a rational number. Other than 0, A by B divided by C by D will be a rational number. So let's check. Now you see 1 by 2 divided by 3 by 2. So 1 by 2 divided, as we have learned in your early class, it will be multiplied and it will be reciprocal of this. So this is almost 2 by 6. So which is also a rational number. So a closure property is also applicable on division, provided that C and D should not be equal to 0. Now come to the next property. Property number 2, the second property. So this is cumulative property. So before going to this cumulative property of rational number, I will just say cumulative property of a natural number. Suppose you see in our previous class, in class 7 class 8, we have studied, suppose 6 plus 2 is equal to 2 plus 6. 6 plus 2 equal to how much? 8. Again, 2 plus 6 is also equal to 8. So this is the cumulative property. Now we will see this cumulative property on rational number. On rational number. So, first we will say on addition, cumulative property on addition. Now you see, suppose A by B is again also a rational number, A by B is a rational number, plus C by D equal to C by D plus A by B. So, now suppose as an example, 1 by 2 plus 3 by say 5 by 2. This will be equal to, this is A by B, it is 1 by 2. C by D is 5 by 2. Now C by D means which one? 5 by 2. So 5 by 2 plus A by B, it is 1 by 2. So here we see 5 plus 1, 6 by 2 equal to 6 by 2. So, cumulative property on addition is applicable. Now, come to the subtraction. So, A by B minus C by D should be equal to C by D minus A by B. So, let's check this. So, 3 by 2 minus 1 by 2. So this is C by D is what? 1 by 2. 1 by 2 minus C by 2. So this is 3 minus 2, 3 minus 1, 2 by 2 equal to 1 minus 3 minus 2. This is 1 equal to minus 1. So this is not equal. So you see A by B minus C by D not equal to C by B minus A by B. That means what? Cumulative property will not be applicable in subtraction. Now check in multiplication. So let's check in multiplication. There is A by B into C by D and C by D into A by B. So, suppose 1 by 2 into 3 by 2 equal to 3 by 2 into 1 by 2. So, 3 by 4 equal to 3 by 4. So, the result is, so, you want the result is coming same, equal. Therefore, cumulative property is applicable in multiplication. Now, check for division. Check for division. Say 1 by 2. Check for division. A by B divided by C by D, which is supposed to be equal to C by D divided by A by B. So, 1 by 2 divided by 3 by 2 equal to 3 by 2 divided by 1 by 2. So, 1 by 2 into 2 by 3 equal to 3 by 2 into 2 by 1. So, this is 1 by 3 and this is 3. So, this here again, the result is not same. Therefore, cumulative property will not work on division. So from here we see that cumulative property works on addition and multiplication and it does not work on subtraction and division.
So this is our cumulative property on rational number. Now come to the next property, that is associative property. Associative property. So again, associative property. Before going to this associative property, just check once then about natural numbers. Suppose 6 plus 2 plus 4. So I have made this 6 plus 2 as one pair. Again, 6 plus 2 plus 4. Here I have left the first one and make the last one as pair. Now you see here 6 plus 2 is almost 8. 8 plus 4. And here again 6 plus 2 plus 4 is 6. The result is almost 12. Here the result is also 12. So this is of natural number. Now let us see to the rational number whether it is applicable or not on addition. So take three rational numbers, say A by B plus C by D plus E by F equal to A by B plus C by D plus E by F. So you see in the first one, I have taken this pair and here I have taken the last one. I have left the first one and made a pair to the last one. So just take an example, 1 by 2 plus 3 by 2 plus 5 by 2 equal to 1 by 2 plus 3 by 2 plus 5 by 2. So here the result is almost 4 by 2 plus 5 by 2 equal to 1 by 2 plus 8 by 2. It is 9 by 2, 9 by 2. So associative property on addition is applicable. So on addition it is applicable. Now let us check on subtraction. So associative property on subtraction will not be applicable. So I am not doing this, you do by yourself. You just check, this will be not applicable. And associative property on multiplication will be applicable, and on division it will be not applicable. So I am not doing this, you do it by yourself. Just check once whether it is applicable or not. Now come to distributive property. Distributive property. So distributive property is nothing but we'll see about the natural number. So 6 into x plus 2. 6 into x plus 2. So this can be written as what? 6. This 6 will be multiplied by x. Again this 6 will be multiplied by 2. So this is 6 into x, 6 multiplied by x, that is 6x plus 6 multiplied by 2 is 12. So this is distributive property. So distributive property on addition and on subtraction and multiplication and division, on which it is applicable, just we'll check. So distributive property on rational number. So suppose rational number A by B into C by D plus E by F. This is for addition. So this will be multiplied by this, again by this. So that is A by B into C by D plus A by B into E by F. So this is our distributive property on addition. So distributive property on addition. very oftenly you find this, you will find this distributive property in an open form. Now distributive property on subsection will be same as this, only here the plus will be minus. So that is A by B, C by D minus E by F, which can be written as A by B into C by D minus A by B into E by F. So this is what distributive property is. Now we'll see edit. Now we'll see multiplicative inverse. Multiplicative inverse. Multiplicative inverse of a rational number. So a rational number, say A by B. So when a multiplicative inverse will be just the reciprocal of this number. So reciprocal of this number is what? 1 by A by B, which is equal to B by A. So this is multiplicative inverse. So suppose 1 by 2, then this will be equal to 2 1, which is your multiplicative inverse. So we have seen all the properties of the rational number which will be helpful in while solving the exercise of this chapter. So in our next video we'll see the exercise of this chapter. Thank you.